Hi, I'm Starborn. Remember, to be a star, you have to shine your own light, follow your own path, and not be afraid of the darkness, because that's when stars shine brightest. Tonight's show is going to cover a fabulous full moon that we just had in Leo, at 19 degrees of Leo. So if you've been looking at our website, starborninstitute.org, you would know that the title of tonight's show is The Look of Sweet Success. And the reason why we can be emphasizing the look of success is because Leo is the traditional ruler of the fifth house of glamour and of Hollywood and entertainment. And it rules the whole sports industry, and it rules children, and it rules things like parties and having a good time. So Leo, which is a sign that is ruled by the sun, Leos are generally very good-humored. They like to have a lot of fun, and they like to be in the limelight. So we say it's a royal sign, and people who are Leos like to be the king or the queen. They would rather host a party than be a guest at one. And so they like looking successful, and that is why with that full moon in Leo, people can be enjoying the sweet look of success right now, because that's what Leo rules. However, there is another reason why they can be enjoying the look of sweet success, and that is because Uranus is in Aries, and Uranus rules the future and things ahead of their time, and it also rules sudden change. So because Uranus is trining that full moon in Leo, there can be a sudden change or a sudden announcement about recognition or reward or some sort of fame or honor that could come your way in the next week, and that would be wonderful. And why would that success be genuine? Because right behind the planet Uranus in Aries is another planet which is actually conjuncting it. Venus, the love planet, is at 29 degrees of Pisces, and Uranus is at only 2 degrees of Aries. They are actually conjuncting, and both of them are the love planets. So you could be enjoying the look of sweet success this week, because not only could it happen sort of right out of the blue and be associated with some sort of new beginning, after all Uranus is in Aries and Aries does rule new starts, but also you could have a little help from your friends behind the scenes. That's what Venus in Pisces represents. So that can be wonderful for you. However, there are some things that can indicate that it is your success could have a few strings attached to it. And what could they be? Well, actually, the funny thing is the full moon that we just had in Leo at 19 degrees is in almost exactly the same spot that a new moon is going to be at in August, in Leo at 25 degrees. And so something that is connected with the look of success right now could lead to very solid success by August. And right now, though, there can be some challenges that will not occur in August. And the challenges can come from the fact that there are other planets in fixed signs. Leo is a fixed sign. But unfortunately, Jupiter in Taurus is squaring that full moon, and that simply means that the look of your success this week could be mighty expensive. It could cost a little more than you think. And so there can be extra costs or expenses connected to your success, but that might be the price of glory. At the same time, since it was a full moon in Leo, we know that under a full moon, the moon opposes the sun. So the sun was at 19 degrees of Aquarius, and along with that is the planet Mercury. They're conjuncting each other. And since they are strongly opposing that full moon, it simply means that even if you're enjoying success this next week, you may have to change your future plans in order to accommodate a sudden change in your status. And so that too could present somewhat of a challenge to you. And that might be worth it anyway. However, there is something that you've got to watch out for, and it is that there are now two retrograde planets, and they are both right in front of the full moon in Leo. And that is because Mars is retrograde in Virgo, and since it is going retrograde, it is demanding that we re-examine the facts about an employment matter or a health condition, or simply about your budget or a bookkeeping matter. And right ahead of Mars in retrograde in Virgo is Saturn, which has now gone retrograde in Libra. So there can be a sort of a double whammy right now that you've got to look out for, because there can be an old legal issue or a partnership issue that is going to have to be resolved. So you could think of these two retrograde planets right in front of that full moon as representing unfinished business that you will have to attend to, even if you are suddenly in the spotlight. All right, what does this mean to all 12 of the sun signs? Well, Aries, for you, it simply means you could be on a roll right now, Aries. And the reason why is because, remember, that full moon in Leo is being trined by Uranus in your sign. And right behind Uranus in your sign is that gentle Venus in Pisces, which is actually conjuncting Uranus. So it can be you, Aries. It's got a little help from your friends behind the scenes. And you can be enjoying or contributing to the success, perhaps of someone else, maybe not of yourself, but you could certainly be benefiting from the look of their success at the moment. And you could be instrumental in obtaining that in one way or another. In other words, you could have something to do with it. Even if it isn't your success, you could certainly be happy about someone else's right now. So that's great. And when Venus actually moves right into your sign, which it's just about to do tomorrow, it will conjunct Uranus. And since those are both the love planets, you certainly could be quite happy about some sort of new start. It may be involving someone else who is being extremely successful at the moment, but it would make you happy too, Aries. All right, what does it mean to a Taurus? Well, Taurus, I think that since yours is a fixed sign and there are some squares and oppositions in fixed signs right now, you may not be thrilled at the success that someone else is going to enjoy right now. And that is because Jupiter in your sign is actually squaring that full moon in Leo. So I'm sure you wouldn't mind if the costs were very high, or you wouldn't mind charging a little extra for something right now, Taurus. After all, you have your own definition of success, and it's not going to be quite the same definition as whoever else is enjoying success this week. So you can be a little bit stubborn, not really jealous, but at least a little bit stubborn. And you could be experiencing some need for extra expenses in your life as well. So you might be sort of having to pay out right now, and that's fine. Remember I said, though, that the Mars in Virgo is retrograde right now, and that is an indication of unfinished business? Well, that planet is beautifully trine your sun, Taurus, and so is Pluto in Capricorn. So there is a strong grand trine in Earth signs right now that will hold until June. But because Mars is retrograde, it simply means you have got to sort of make up for lost time, Taurus, and you have got to go back and address a health issue, an employment matter, or some sort of budget problem before it really balloons into something even bigger. And so that's what you really need to sort of pay attention to now, not fame and glory, but just getting all the details worked out so that you are not caught short, or so that something does not get to be super expensive by the time Mars goes direct in April. What does it mean to a Gemini? Well, Gemini, this is simply a time when you are in sort of a comfortable spot. Maybe I would call it a sweet spot, Gemini. And the reason why is because the full moon in Leo was sextile your sun. So somewhere in your near vicinity, Gemini, you would know somebody who can be enjoying the look of sweet success right now. And that could reflect well upon you. At the same time, the Sun and Mercury, your ruler in Aquarius, are trining your Sun, and so is Saturn in Libra. Saturn has now gone retrograde, though, Gemini, and that simply means some strong support or backup that you have been enjoying for well over a year, or perhaps for even longer than that, is not going to be quite as strongly in your favor anymore. And that is because whoever has been supporting you has troubles of their own. They may be just plain tired, or it may be that they are thinking of going in a different direction. They could even be thinking of retiring, or simply not wanting to have so many activities or so many burdens right now, and so they are not going to be quite as supportive of you as you have become accustomed to, Gemini. So you could be taking someone for granted who isn't really going to be there anymore, Gemini. And that's why, with good news about your future, because the Sun and Mercury are trining your Sun, I hope that you are heading out for new friends and that you meet new people in new places, because you're going to need some other backup, since the standard ones are going to be leaving you in fairly soon. Okay, what does it mean to a Cancer? Well, Cancer, this is simply a time when you can be delighted with the look of success that someone else can be enjoying right now. And you probably know who that person is, Cancer. And the reason why is that full moon in Leo was right ahead of your sun sign. So someone quite near to you, it could be a child or a family member, or it could be somebody that you know well in your neighborhood or at your workplace, is going to be basking in some genuine success right now, or recognition, which is wonderful. And so I don't think it's necessarily coming to you, Cancer, but I do think that it reflects well upon you, and that it somehow someone else's success can be somewhat of a credit to you as well, and that's good. What's even better is that Venus is still in Pisces trine your sun, and Neptune is now in that sign as well. And so both of them together are trining your sun, which means that behind the scenes, you could certainly have a little help from your friends. Or it can simply be that something is reaching a culmination where you, if you have been working on something behind the scenes, it could be wrapping up, or it could be entering a better stage right now, and that can make you happy as well. Okay, what does it mean to a Leo? Well, Leo, that full moon was in your sun sign, so of course it's you, Leo, that can be enjoying the look of sweet success. And it could be somewhat of a surprise to you, and it could be associated with some sort of new beginning. You may have already initiated the new beginning, or maybe someone else has. But whatever their bright idea is, it's going to reflect awfully well on you, Leo, and it can sort of put you into the spotlight. So the success is genuine. And even if it does come suddenly, you would certainly enjoy it. But remember, the hint now is that it is the look of success, and that simply means there can be challenges to it. There won't be any challenges by August, but there are now, because Jupiter in Taurus is square that full moon in your sign, and that means that whatever success you're going to enjoy, it's going to be a little pricey, Leo. So I hope you have deep pockets or you have some savings, because you're probably going to have to pay a higher price than you would like in association with some success. But I would do it, think of it as investing in yourself. The other challenge is that the full moon was being opposed by the Sun and Mercury in Aquarius, which rules the future. So it simply means that the look of success is going to require some sort of change in your future plans. So I hope that you can be flexible. Fixed signs such as yours are usually not flexible whatsoever, but you've got to adjust to changing trends, Leo, and you've got to step forward and sort of make up for lost time. Things that you perhaps did not work out well last year can be working out very well this year for you, but you just have to get ready, because I mentioned, Leo, that the two planets that are retrograde, Mars in Virgo and Saturn in Libra, are both right ahead of your sun sign, and that means you have a lot of unfinished business that you must attend to. So don't let that success go to your head, Leo. Try to keep your feet on the ground and keep going forward little by little, paying attention to details and wrapping up or resolving legal or partnership issues so that everything is clean and clear by August, when you can really enjoy solid success without any challenges to it. Okay, what does it mean to a Virgo? Well, Virgo, remember I said Mars is in your sign, but it is retrograde, and now Virgo, Saturn right ahead of your sign, is also retrograde. So you really do have a lot of unfinished business that you have to attend to. And as you go back and re-examine facts, or as you try to improve your health right now, not just your physical health, but your mental attitude about things as well. You can make great strides in that, and when you are trying to re-examine facts, you might be very surprised that what you thought was okay before is not, and you're going to have to sort of add things up again. But you are very good at problem solving, Virgo, so you can really do that. And between now and April, when Mars goes direct again, you have got to come up with some really concrete answers to things or concrete results, and you can do that. That full moon was actually right behind your sun sign, which means in the background of your life, Virgo, there is something to celebrate, which can be good news or success connected with a child or with a loved one or with somebody that you know or even something that you are associated with, but it's in the background of your life. It can certainly be very rewarding right now. Congratulations. Okay, what does it mean to a Libra? Well, Libra, this is simply a time when you can decide that, you know, going forward at all costs is not really worth it if you're not ready. And that is very true. And you are being realistic if you have that attitude. You are still in a good spot, though, because the full moon in Leo was sextile your sun, but you have Saturn in your sun sign, and it is now retrograde, which means you do know you have to go back and check a few things, or you have to iron out some paperwork or straighten up some matters that have to do with legal matters, or with partnerships, or business affairs, or contracts, and you've really got to get that all cleaned up. The news about your future can be excellent, though, Libra, and that's because the Sun and Mercury in Aquarius are trining your Sun. So that's good. So as you do get good news about your future plans, you still would be smart if you went back and checked to make sure that every single tiny little bit of legal work that you had to do to initiate a new start for your future is done correctly. So I would just double check everything and not take anything for granted right now, because it does look like the future is going to open up for you, Libra, but you better make sure you've closed a few doors to your past first. Okay, what does it mean to a Scorpio? Well, Scorpio, there are quite a few planets in fixed signs, and yours is a fixed sign too. So that full moon in Leo was actually squaring your sun sign, meaning that someone else is going to enjoy a little bit of glory or fame or honor or recognition right now, and it may not be you, but still quite suddenly they can step into the spotlight and do that. You may not be too interested in that though, Scorpio, because Jupiter in Taurus is opposing your sun, so you can be involved with thinking about the high cost of living or a tax matter that is coming up, and that might be enough for you to ponder right now. Also, the Sun and Mercury in Aquarius are squaring your Sun, so there isn't anything in your Sun sign, Scorpio, but you got a whole lot of trouble if you step out and want to challenge somebody right now. So I advise you not to. In other words, you could step up to the plate, you could go to war right now, after all your sign does rule war. You could tackle some subject that involves injustice because your sign rules justice instead and you hate injustice. But if you decide to engage with other people who are terribly stubborn and have ideas of their own, it will cost you, Scorpio. It's going to take a great deal of effort. You could even win, but it still would require an awful lot of energy, and it may take you off the focus of what's really important to you, which is something behind the scenes that is making you happy right now. And I know that because Venus and Neptune are in Pisces, and they're trining your sun, Scorpio. So why don't you stay out of the fray right now? And when people want to set up challenges, why don't you just ignore them for right now, Scorpio? Because the planets in Pisces are aspecting your sun sign so well that I think you've got your mind on something that's a little bit secretive right now that can represent a great deal of joy for you. And that is, you know, if it's a secret joy that you are thinking about right now, why don't you just stick to that? It'll make you much happier. Okay, what does it mean to a Sagittarian? Well, Sagittarius, I think that you are really exactly in the right place at the right time right now, and you could use a little good luck, couldn't you, Sagittarius? Despite challenges from people who are sort of nitpicking at you and wanting you to, who can be critical of you and can want you to almost start over on something right now, or despite the fact that you may have a nagging health problem that you are somewhat refusing to address, that because Mars is in Virgo squaring your sun, I think that you are going to be delighted with the fact that someone else, remember that full moon was in Leo, is probably going to enjoy some sort of fame or recognition right now, and they certainly will be enjoying that look of sweet success. This can reflect wonderfully on you, Sagittarius, because Leo trines your sun sign. And also Uranus in Aries is trining your sun sign as well. So there is a lot of strength in the fire signs right now. And so I advise everyone to sort of prepare to be extra busy in the next week, because fire signs like to go into action. And it looks like the planets are lining up very favorably for all of us to be very busy. Well, you would love that, Sagittarius, because it could involve travel, which is what your sign rules, or higher education, or it could simply involve learning something new that can lead you on the road to success along with other people. So I think you'll be joining a group or joining some other people who really want to be busy right now. And that is the best thing for you, Sagittarius, because that way you can get your mind off your troubles. All right, what does it mean to a Capricorn? Well, Capricorn, you really have to stick to business just like Taurus does, because there are two planets that are retrograde right now, and one of them is Mars in Virgo, and so that simply means you've got to go back and address a health issue or perhaps an employment matter or else just some budget matters that you have to get straightened out. You know, you sort of have to make sure everything adds up right now. That isn't the problem. The problem is that Saturn has now gone retrograde in Libra, but it is strongly squaring your sun, and of course Saturn is your sun sign ruler. So there is a legal matter or a partnership issue that you must go back and re-examine, Capricorn, and there couldn't be a better time for it than now, because you have got a lot of support. Jupiter in Taurus is trining your sun, and that Mars, even though it's retrograde, is in Virgo, and it too is trining your sun. So if you needed to go to other people to get the answers to some problems right now, or just to get your questions answered about a legal issue or a partnership issue or a contract, you could find the right people to talk to, Capricorn, and I urge you to do that now and get things straightened out, because these two planets going retrograde mean that everyone has some unfinished business that they now need to attend to. But while you're under such good aspects, Capricorn, this is the time for you to do that. Okay, what does it mean to an Aquarian? Well, Aquarius, remember that full moon was in Leo, and so that means the full moon was opposing your sun sign precisely, because the moon was at 19 of Leo and the sun in your sign is at 19 of Aquarius, and Mercury is right there conjuncting the sun as well. So you can be full of bright ideas or a lot of plans for the future, but I don't think this is the time when you are going to be enjoying the look of sweet success. Someone else is going to get that honor or that award or that recognition right now. This may not bother you though, Aquarius, because I think you're all ready to launch something new and that you do have your plans in place right now. Saturn, though, which is trining your sun, is now retrograde, and that simply means that you, before you take a step forward, Aquarius, you really better check the fine print to make sure that all the terms of some sort of agreement are spelled out exactly. In other words, they're written down in black and white. Because if you're going to be signing any kind of a contract, you better make sure that that contract has everything in it the way you want it, Aquarius, rather than the way someone else wants it. And so it wouldn't be a bad idea to stall for a little while until you get everything just the way you want it before you go ahead and launch your plans. And you must realize that success can be delayed a little bit right now, and so can the money. And that is because there are these planets in fixed signs, and since the Leo is a fixed sign and the moon is opposing your sun, other people sort of want to take the spotlight away from you, Aquarius, so they probably will. And Jupiter in Taurus is squaring your sun, which means whatever you're going to do is going to cost more. Or if you don't have the money or you're expecting some money to come in, I think that there will be a delay in that as well. So you have to be a little bit practical. And since Saturn is retrograde, it's the same as for Gemini. That backup that you have been had for a long time is probably going to be going away, and you're going to have to need to be much more resilient on your own right now. Okay, what does it mean to Pisces? Well, Pisces, the Neptune is now in your sign, and that full moon was 150 degrees away from your sun or in conjunct. So I don't think you're going to be too involved with someone else who's going to enjoy the sweet look of success. But Pisces, I don't think it'll matter to you because you've got Neptune in your sign, which is your ruler, which can make you very creative right now. And you've still got Venus in your sign, which means that you can have your mind on love. And so I think you can just be happy all by yourself right now, Pisces. And I hope that you remember that as Venus goes into Aries right ahead of your sign, both love planets will be ahead of your sign. And that simply means the month of February means you've got to sort of reach out and try new things in order to be happy. And I'm sure you'll be good at that. All right. Thanks so much for tuning in. I'll see you next week right here on Thursdays at 7 p.m. for Starborn. And if for any reason you are enjoying the sweet look of success right now this week, I think it will be coming quite suddenly to you. And it may not last forever, but I think that whatever success you are going to be enjoying this week will be genuine. It will be something that could be a golden opportunity that comes right out of the blue. Well, I'd sure say yes to it if I were you. Or it can simply be that if you've been working on some new start, suddenly it can get off the ground because a lot of other people with vision can agree with you about that. All right, thanks so much for tuning in. I'll see you next week right here on Thursdays at 7 p.m. for Starborn. Bye.